Squad Captain Lopez, reporting on Expedition 17B. At the formation now, visually no distinction from the previous visit. The link detectors are still standing. One arch has a light flashing, so we're gonna give the area once over. Then we'll head back. Lopez out.
They're all dead. Please kill them all. There are so many.
Yeah. Guess the song ended. Good timing.
Anyone here?
Guess not. Seems a lot more crowded than the rest of the bureau. That gate should open.
Thank you.
I'm no detective, but something definitely happened here.
Each other? I feel this feels familiar. I can't seem to. I've forgotten it. I'm sorry. My name is Alan Wake.
Zane. There's nothing to worry about.
Tom. The poet. The diver, you look different.
That was just a role. A character. The protagonist I played in my old film. I'm a filmmaker. An auteur like yourself. We're working on this together, remember? An artistic collaboration. You need a drink.
Was Alan Wake, the writer who went missing in that AWE case I read about. What's he doing here? And Thomas Zane was with him. The poet. No, wait. He was a filmmaker. I always remember that wrong.
Dr. Emil Hartman, devoured by hungry darkness. I can't...
Dr. Emil Hartman was desperate. The Federal Bureau of Control had stolen his life's work. This was his last chance, his final experiment. What he'd been too scared to do before. Hartman dove into the lake, was taken, devoured by hungry darkness, became the thing that had been Hartman. Only an echo of him remained, fragmented impulses on autoplay, violent, bloodthirsty darkness in the driver's seat. Emerging from the lake, the thing was captured by the FPC, brought in, contained, studied. The thing broke loose, killed everyone it could. The FPC fell back and sealed the sector. The thing was alone in the dark, lurking, roaming, waiting. Then something else came. Not darkness, but similar enough. A sound. A resonance. It shouldn't be a surprise. If there's one, why not another? The darkness inside the thing could have been immune, could have resisted, fought, could have been passed by, passed through with no effect. But it didn't, and it wasn't. Maybe it had grown weaker over time, not aged. It was timeless, but weaker with no link to its source. A metamorphosis followed. The thing that had been Hartman went through another change. The thing that had been Hartman broke loose, killed everyone it could, lurking, roaming, waiting. Then something else came, a resonance. The thing that had been Hartman went through another change.
Wake want me to come here. That doesn't look like a house shift. Do I even want to know? course, the Hiss are already in here. Whoa. Looks like the house has gotten a little wild in here. This darkness is blocking the door, so now I have to deal with an interdimensional noise and sentient shadows. Thank you.
third thing. The sound made darker the dark.
The resonance carves its way through the thing that had been Artman, vibrating, remolding. The sound changes the darkness, and the darkness changes the sound. They both changed what remained of Artman. They all turned into something else. A third thing. The sound made darker. The darkness made louder. Artman was stretched. Stretched as anyone when seen from out of time, like a worm through time. Almost an Ouroboros, a spiral, a maelstrom. The gravity well of a black hole, twisting inward, tightening, taking you deeper and deeper to the bottom, the heart, and through to the other side. The third thing said, when you hear this, you will know you're a new you. He said, we build you till nothing remains. He said, under the conceptual reality, behind this reality, you must want these ways to drag you away. He said, baby, 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 yeah, orange peel. The third thing was a monster. He'd tear apart any ordinary person crossing his path. Now he crashed out of darkness toward Faden. There was nothing ordinary about Faden.
Just made louder. Artman was stretched like a worm through time. The third thing was a monster. Now he crashed out of darkness toward Faden.
captured here have died standing up. Lighten them up.
Ah, more plants. All right, let's go make some new friends.
The air here is getting bad. The vents, they are full of mold shit. It's no good for you. Headache, nauseous, mold, depression. How can you tell when you are winning? Darkness everywhere. New day, same old bloody city, said the old way. Like tar, but good for nothing. Get rid of it.
Reminder, all employees are required to report their hours at the end of each month. The Federal Bureau of Control maintains that time is not subjective, and hours passed on alternative planes cannot be claimed. Astral dives do not accumulate overtime compensation. Thank you for your attention.
My understanding of the darkness is fragmented, incomplete. This abyss, this void, it very much does not wish to be understood. If light symbolizes knowledge, then it stands to reason that darkness would equate to ignorance. By its very nature, it abhors comprehension. Of course, my own nature drives me to comprehend all. We are opposing forces, destined to collide. And given this conflict of natures, we know that the light of truth will burn away the darkness, both figuratively and literally. Any significant light source can be used as protection, even weaponry against this metaphysical gloom. And then there are the artists. I know for a fact that Tom, Wake, the Anderson brothers, and Lane all had some involvement with the darkness. The question is whether their uncanny ability to affect reality through their art beckons the darkness, or did their work perhaps even create it? With Wake now secure in my lodge, I expect I shall grow closer to learning the answers to these questions. Assuming he cooperates, which is proving quite the challenge. Well, perseverance is the foundation of knowledge. Speaking of, I must be off on my rounds.
Doesn't that feel better? Welcome back to the land of the living, little buddy.
Thank you.
Something in this darkness is draining me.
Brian Hennerman, 21 years old, resident of Southern Texas.
I'm sorry, ma'am, but I really don't understand why I'm here.
You know what you did, Mr. Hennerman.
I do?
Tell me about Delivery Disaster.
The movie? It wasn't very good.
That's not what your review said, but we'll come back to that. Tell me where you got the movie from.
Movie night, with a, a K, not an N, not night, like nighttime, but...
Who contacted you? Who told you to review that film?
No one. I just did it because it looked obscure. I didn't even like the movie. I shouldn't have given such a high score, but reviewing obscure films makes you look smart. And I thought if I looked smart, I would get listeners. My podcast would take off and I could move out of my parents' basement. I may even go to college and get a film degree like I've always wanted to. I swear.
Okay, the kid doesn't know shit. I'm ending the session.
Machines. Shoom.